Microsoft Intune Endpoint Privilege Management increases organizational efficiency and security by automating IT-established permissions for standard users. It is available as a standalone add-on service to a current subscription that includes Intune or as part of the Microsoft Intune suite. By eliminating the need for local admins, it keeps the entire enterprise more secure. It also reduces attack surfaces and protects corporate data by enabling least privileged access. With this policy-based elevation capability, organizations can modernize IT work streams and increase employee productivity without compromising security. Endpoint Privilege Management also gives IT visibility into what's happening behind the scenes by providing a comprehensive view of elevations across the organization. This first demo shows how that view can inform an automatic elevation rule. Danielle is reviewing elevation usage data from her enterprise and notices that a large number of the finance staff have been engaging her support team to install a new application. To reduce costs and cut down on support requests, Danielle and her team decide that they should create a rule to automate the elevation of privileges needed for the installation of this application, removing the need for their end users to call support. Using the data that she has from the Endpoint Privilege Management Elevation Report, she begins creating a rule for the application. In the Endpoint Privilege Management section of the Endpoint Security Blade, she selects Create Policy. On the flyout, she selects her platform and elevation rules policy from the type. After selecting Add, she now decides how she wants to automate the elevation. Danielle edits the instance User Confirmed Elevation. She then requires a business justification from the user to elevate the application and complete the installation. She chooses the option to use a signature of the application, which ensures that only applications signed by this publisher are allowed to elevate. She has the option to specify any further metadata to be used as conditions for elevation and deploys the policy exclusively to the finance department. With this rule in place, any member of the finance department will be able to install this app without having to call the help desk, increasing their productivity and reducing the number of help desk calls. Now, let's look at a scenario where a user initiates a request for elevation. Adele works for the finance department and has just been approved to validate a new application to estimate project finances. Since Adele does not have administrative rights, she engages with her support desk to get the application installed. First, Adele requests to run the application as administrator. She does this by right-clicking on the installer and selecting Run with Elevated Access. She is met with a pane asking her to submit a business justification. Adele completes the request and sends it off to her support team. In Microsoft Intune, her support team reviews the request, ensuring the file matches expectations. They can review items like the device's compliance and the justification provided by Adele. They can also view detailed information about the signature and file metadata, making sure the request is from a file they can trust. After reviewing the request, they approve it for a limited period of time, only for Adele and only on her device. Adele gets notification of the approval and launches the application. She is asked to confirm the privilege elevation, selects Continue, and the installation launches with administrative privileges, allowing Adele to get to work. All of this was done on Adele's device without her or the support person having privileged or admin rights, or having to enter privileged credentials. For even more details about Endpoint Privilege Management, visit aka.ms/epmskills.